sound check has come to the toy fair. We're here at Earls Court in London, partly to look at the toys, but mostly to talk to Julian Cope. One-time toy smasher and lead singer of the Teardrop Explodes, he's now a reformed man, an avid toy collector and a solo artist. He's just released his new single called Beautiful Love, which won the video vote not so long ago. We're here, hopefully, to have a chat. But first of all, we've got to find him. Scotland 3, Brazil 0. Eat your heart out, Dragon. This game is more than 40 years old and is played in around 26 countries. And it's just won Best Action Game of 1990. If you've ever wondered what it's like to walk on the moon, the way you do, these are supposed to help you find out. They're called moon shoes, or to give them their formal name, anti-gravity devices. They are actually supposed to give you the sensation that you're walking on the moon. Well, this should be easy. This is for four-year-olds. All I have to do is put this inside the clown's box without making him laugh. Easy. Okay, here we go. Shut up! There are currently over 500 million of them. If you laid each one head to toe, they'd go round the world 3.5 times. If you bought one in 1959, today it could be worth well over £2,000. What are they? Barbie dolls. Every year, Barbie makes over £300 million. That's 20 times the salary that Madonna earns. The world's biggest collection is owned by Mrs. Irina Creaser. She's got over 600 dolls, and that's worth £1 million. Another little-known fact is another collector is the pop star Julian Cope, which is probably why he's just over there.
Where's Jakki? I've been waiting over an hour. I hope she arrives. Oh. I'm going in danger of being deleted.
Oh, Julian, I'm so sorry I'm late.
Oh, Jakki, I thought you were going to stand me up.
How could I possibly stand you up when I'm wearing such a fabulous frock and I've got so many things to ask you? Like, Julian Cope, why do you collect 150 Barbie dolls? So tell me about some of the ones that you've got.
My favourite one's Feeling Groovy Barbie, who came out in 1987. She's a designer doll that Billy Boy did with specially lightened vinyl skin and special extras, and she's just so cool.
And what about the oldest one you've got? You said that was from 87.
Yeah.
The oldest one?
The oldest one's about 1961. They're just so representative of the time, you know? I mean, like, that period they look like Lucille Ball in I Love Lucy. And they move on to, like, the psychedelic period in the 60s. They get very, they introduced Francie. But Francie was the Francie was Barbie's modern cousin. She was the English girl with the go-go boots and the Carnaby Street clothes.
I read somewhere that when you were in your childhood years, you were actually quite destructive with your toys. You didn't care for them at all.
I always used to think that people who looked after their toys were kind of sissy-ish.
A bit wimpish.
And being called Julian and being brought up in the Midlands, that meant that I was, you know, a lot of people didn't like me because of the kind of person that I appeared to be, that I represented. So I had to be tough with my toys.
You make my life for so long. They make believe it ain't so wrong. Beautiful love now, beautiful love, where have you gone?
I think people dream of being on Top of the Pops from, you know, from childhood. But as soon as we got on Top of the Pops, we didn't like it. So it was a tremendous overreaction. I think it really took me like 3 years after the Teardrop split up to realize, you know, what the group was about.
I leave my life in one for you.
Didn't all this collecting of toys start when the Teardrop Explodes ended?
Yeah, suddenly I had an enormous amount of free time. I realized that a lot of the stuff that I was writing about was my childhood, and I started to explore it. And this one day, I bought this old corgi toy that I bought on holiday in Cornwall in 1967, and I found the exact toy car. I opened it up. And it was almost like that time of opening up the toy car
first time?
I was suddenly back in Cornwall in 1967, and I started to become obsessed with reliving that moment, because moments are... That's what childhood's made up of, you know? These times when suddenly something is revealed to you about the world, and you think, the world's not going to be the same after I know this.
And even when you live, it doesn't matter when you live. You're my beautiful love, beautiful love.
So we've talked a little bit about the toy man, Julian Cope. Yeah. Let's talk about the music man. Did you feel successful once you were topping the charts?
No.
Being famous?
No, I felt like a terrible failure, because a lot of the time I was... People were liking songs, but they weren't really seeing what they were about.
Or understanding what you were trying
to
say.
Yeah, what? And then I realised that more than anything, that wasn't their fault, that was my fault, because I wasn't being clear enough.
My beautiful love.
What are you striving for now? Everybody knows who Julian Cope is. We've heard the music, we know the face, we've seen the videos. What is it you want to achieve now with the new album and the second launch?
I want people to be into the idea that the 90s is not what the 80s was. The 80s was a celebration of money, it was a celebration of greed, it was a celebration of getting rid of the community, and everybody is an individual, and every man for themselves. And I don't believe that. I believe that the minute you think in terms of money and every man for himself, then you're beaten